This is the Own It Show, where we tell stories of how everyday people made ownership theirs to create extraordinary success.
Hello, and welcome to the Own It Show, weekly wind down edition.
Cheers. Blink. First time in a separate location.
First time, and that means you get 2-for-1 wines because Justin and I are drinking different things. So I am drinking a French rosé. It's called Domaine du Paris. It's a 2020 from Côte de Provence, and it is very, very refreshing. It's a rosé. I don't know if I said that, but it's pink. I think you can tell.
And I'm drinking a white. It's Imagery. Yes, we finished the bottle. And it's absolutely delicious. I don't have a French accent like Elise does, so it's
good thing it's not a French wine.
Imagery Chardonnay. So again, check it out. But if you listen to the podcast on Monday, if you haven't, be sure to go like, subscribe, share, because our guest Darren Heitner was really instrumental in changing a lot of things for up and coming athletes. And it's so unique in the way in which he did it from a truly authentic way. I don't know if you've been around sports much, but not many people have the ability to act the way that he does and truly own who he is. And it showed in the success that he's garnered in his feat. And when we asked him about ownership, it was ownership is responsibility. It's taking responsibility for yourself, taking responsibility for your industry, taking responsibility for your job, your actions, your decisions, and being able to know that you're not only responsible for the moment in which you're acting, but the results in which they produce.
And if I can layer on top of that, you know, that was his immediate definition of ownership, but he, in the way that he spoke, it was very clear that he had an ownership mindset. He consistently shows up in his own authentic way in a world where it's suit and tie every single day. He oftentimes shows up in a t-shirt and a baseball hat because that's who he is. And he made a really interesting statement that actually really resonated with me, because what he said was, I think we all owe it ourselves to be a little bit more authentic and be more in alignment with who we are every single day. So he doesn't wake up and settle for who he was yesterday. He wakes up and continues to be who he is that day and the next day and the next day. And to almost continue to push himself to, if his alignment changes a little bit, to make sure he's in alignment with that new version of himself, even if it's a degree of a difference than who he was yesterday. But instead of just waking up and saying, nope, this is who I am today, he continues to push those bounds every single day. And for me, that shows really strong, amazing ownership.
I love that example you give, Elise, because so often we find ourselves approaching a mountain. And I can even give some examples that we've seen over the last, like very recently, the last couple of weeks, where people will go through, say, the ownership manual, and they'll create an action plan for themselves. And they'll do it once, and then, oh, here's my action plan, and then take the steps necessary and then put it away, never look at it again. And all of a sudden, if you think about it, it's, oh, I've crested to a peak of a mountain, and now I'm literally just sitting on top of this mountain, and I've found this new version of myself. And we think that the mountaintop is the end. But in actuality, no, it's a false summit every single time. Because like Elise said, we have to continually get better from there and better from there and better from there. And the moment we choose not to take ownership over that, and the moment we choose to just throw that plan in the closet or in the drawer and not look at it anymore, that's the moment we start come tumbling down. We start slowly start getting worse, and slowly start regressing in a lot of those things that we've progressed in so heavily. And the people that are the best in the world, they want to keep getting better. They want to keep impacting. They want to keep striding forward in so many different ways. And the way that Darren summed it up so nicely is continuing to do so every single morning. And Matthew McConaughey actually has a great quote. He was during one of his speeches, and he was up on stage, and he goes, somebody asked me who my hero was. And he goes, my hero is myself. And the guy kind of looked at him and goes, gives him like a weird look. He's like, that's a conceited answer. And he goes, it's myself 5 years from now. And he goes, if I look back on myself 5 years from now and I'm the same person, he goes, I have failed miserably. And so it's the ability to continue to develop, continual and never-ending improvement. That acronym of can I, continual and never-ending improvement, allows us to truly get to that next stage and push ourselves and take responsibility to get there. And that's where that true success ultimately does come from.
Yeah, I mean, it's so true. And, you know, that Matthew McConaughey example, it reminds me of something I posted over the weekend. It was a quote from Mel Robbins, and she said, you need to hear this loud and clear. No one is coming. It's up to you. And really what that's saying is we have to be our own white knight, right? It's not your partner. It's not your parents. It's not your sibling. It's not goosebumps. Your best friend.
Goosebumps.
At the end of the day, we have to be our own white knight. And it's really powerful that when we take a little step every single day to continue to show up for ourselves, be the best version of our own, of ourselves, and be our own white knight, that is the definition of ownership is responsibility. So I hope you guys enjoyed this today. Loved chatting with you. Remember, success is different. Be different and own it. Cheers to you.